बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ली अला सय्यिदना मौलाना मुहम्मदिन वला आलिहि वसहबिहि बारिक वसल्लम वसल्ली अलैहि। ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। मे अलमाइटी ब्लेस ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ माय स्पीच इज व्हाट वाज द कॉज ऑफ द इंसिडेंट ऑफ कर्बला एंड व्हाई एंड हाउ हज़रत इमाम हुसैन रज़ियल्लाहु तआला अन्हु अलॉन्ग साइड हिज फैमिली मेंबर्स 19 अप्रॉक्सिमेटली फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड ऑल टुगेदर 72 the companions, children, and the rest of all Muslims and their children, they've been killed and they've been martyred in the battlefield in the city of Karbala, currently a place in Iraq. What was the situation and how did it happen? When Yazid became king after Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was not eligible basically. So he was forcing Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu to give him a right of vote, to consider him his ruler, so that the rest of people from Makkah and Medina, it will be easy for them to consider Yazid as a sort of caliph or sort of a king, a ruler of a Muslim society and Muslim country. So he was not eligible and he was involved in wrongdoings, and he was far away from the capabilities being a caliph or being a sort of ruler of Muslim community or Muslim society or Muslim country. Yazid been told if four people they perform bat means they give you a right of vote, they consider you yourself as a king or a caliph, sort of caliph, it will be easy, it will be a propagation and a great announcement and easy for the rest of whole Muslim entire Muslim community from Makkah and Medina everywhere. So you will be a ruler for a long, long time. So he was forcing. So when Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he came across this, and the people from Yazid and the the delegations from police and his army, they were forcing and they were chasing Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was not wanting the bloodshed and any wrongdoings in the two major holy cities in Makkah and Medina. So he left Madinatul Munawwara, he went to the Makkah. He was avoiding to face them. So they were chasing and they were forcing. Alongside people from Kufa, approximately 12,000 letters they written to Imam Hussain. Oh, Imam Hussain, you come here, we will give you right of oath and you are our ruler, because you are a grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have all sorts of eligibility and capabilities being a ruler or by being a caliph of Muslim community and Muslim Ummah. So we will give you right of vote. You are our leader, become our leader, please come here and don't leave us alone. So we are fed up from Yazid and his army and his way of ruling principles. So Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he sent his cousin Hazrat Sayyidina Muslim bin Akil alongside his two innocent children to assess the situation. As Hazrat Muslim bin Akil, Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his cousin, he went there in Kufa, he led the prayer. People, they respected and they showed a lot of sentiments and love and respect towards him, Hazrat Muslim bin Akil. And then he wrote a written letter, "Oh brother, Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, situation is very suitable for us, please you come here." And as he written the letter, is sort of a message for the Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Yazidi army and Yazidi people, they caught Hazrat Muslim bin Akil and his children. Somehow they martyred him as well. And all the Kufis, they turned back and they ran off. They didn't stand with Hazrat Muslim bin Akil. So basically, they turned off whatever they said and they requested, they written thousand letters to Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu as an invitation. Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he been told, don't go there, Kufi, they are not faithful and with yourself, and they can cheat you, they can deceive you, they can turn their backs. So Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I had a dream of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala sallam. I will act upon according to my dream. Basically, I will act upon as I've been told by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala sallam. He traveled towards Karbala, and Ubaidullah bin Zayd, Ubaidullah Yazid, appointed Abadullah bin Ziyad the governor of the Kufa, and there was the army, and his army leader was Umar bin Saad. All these people, they were given initiative. They said, okay, if you force Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu to give bath of Yazid, we will give you the prizes and the gifts and everything, and might be you will be the governor of this city and this province. So all they were together and they were forcing Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu for the bath of Yazid. Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, he is not eligible. I can't bath, I can't give right of vote, I can't consider him as a leader of Muslim Ummah till the day of judgment. So in this discussion, and they were so cruel and they were so zalim, they did not see the maqam and fazilat and shan of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They forgot in the love of dunya, in the love of their lavish lust for the dunya, they forgot what are the human rights, what is the message of peace in Islam. They forgot everything because they were too much involved in the love of dunya, and they sort of they became blind. So with the Yazid permission, Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, alongside with his 6-month-old Hazrat Sayyidina Ali Asghar, his son, Hazrat Imam Qasim, his nephew, he was Hazrat Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu's son, 18 years old, his son Hazrat Sayyidina Ali Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was resembling with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People, they used to see Hazrat Ali Akbar, they used to see, oh, he is exactly like a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was a shabihi of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Alongside his nephews, Ono Muhammad, they were the sons of Hazrat Sayyidina Zainab. She is the sister of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala. Altogether 19 people, with brutality and cruelty, they've been killed, they've been murdered. And they were not allowed to drink the water of Nahr-e Farat. So Yazid and army, they appointed their police and their army alongside the Farat, so that Ali Rasul and people, they came from Madinatul Munawwara, they were the children of the Sahaba Ikram, the relative of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they should not get water to drink even. So in the thirst, in the place of Karbala, Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, alongside his family members, the rest of his Jan Nisaran, friends, and they were the families of Sahaba Ikram Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, 72 people, they've been martyred. That is the incident of Karbala. It occurred, it happened 10th of Muharram al-Haram. All over the world, people, they observe, we respect that, and we praise that, the bravery of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And people, they make a sort of promise to, they will be avoiding the zulm o sitam of Yazid, and they recognize the truthfulness and being on haq of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They recognize the zulm of brutality of Yazid and Yazidi army. So till the day of judgment, people, they observe, they say salam upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Ali Rasul Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and shuhada'i Karbala, shuhada mean the people, they've been martyred in the battlefield of Karbala. And we recognize and we pay respect, people, they perform charity, people, they make a promise and agreement, they will act upon the great teaching of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and shuhada'i Karbala. And it is a great lesson for us. We should be very truthful. We should never bow our knees in front of any batil, in front of any zalim, and we should be always with the Husseini. And after the martyrdom of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his head was, astaghfirullah ma'adallah, chopped off with brutality. Head was presented in the courtyard of Kufa, Kufa's governor, and the governor of the Kufa, he was putting a stick on the lips of Imam Hussain. Zayd bin Arqam, his Sahabi Rasul, companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, stop. And wallahi, khuda ki qasam, wallahi, I have seen Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to kiss these lips of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he said, I will kill you. If you wouldn't have been an old person, I would have killed you. So people, they were there, they used to show love of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. On the other hand, and people, they saw, especially Sayyid Ummul Mu'mineen Sayyida Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala, she had a dream. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, collecting the khun of the blood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, collecting blood of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala in a very small bottle, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being asked by Hazrat Umm Salama, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is you are collecting? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied in a dream, it is the khun and blood of Hussain, he being martyred in Karbala. I was there. And then Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas had a dream, likewise dream. So shuhada Karbala ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, and great lesson of truth, being on haq, and showed us the righteous path, showed us the Islam path of Islam, and showed us we should be Husseini, we should be always practicing solely peace, and the brutality and the zulm and the fitna and fasad is always Yazidi and Kufis, their way. We should be all the time in whatsoever circumstances as very peaceful and loving towards Ali Rasul and Sahaba Karam. Ridwanullah Ta'ala Ali Majmain. Wama alayna inal balagh. Jazakallah khair.